when Lynn didn't show up, there was this possibility, kind of lurking in the air, that something had happened to her. And kids were saying maybe Stephen had something to do with it.
I saw Stephen going into the woods with Harper. They were looking for Cass.
Oh, Stephen just took her over to see the ponies. She's gone hitchhiking somewhere.
Did you hear about Stephen and Lynn? Is that true?
Butch, are you saying I took Lynn Harper into the woods?
No.
Cut it out, Butch. I mean it. I wasn't in the woods with Lynn.
Stephen sounded threatening. He was upset.
I'd be upset, too, if someone is accusing me of something I didn't do.
What really interested me in this story is what it must have been like to be a child in the classroom with Stephen and Lynn and have one classmate who's 12 years old found raped and murdered, and then the other classmate who's 14 years old, who's the popular, shy guy, sporty, really nice, he's convicted of that crime and sentenced to hang at the age of 14. So when I was trying to find my way into the story, that really interested me, that what it must have been like as those kids. In 1959, we really had a trust in authority. And we still do to some extent today, but not like we did in 1959.
The men all spread out in a line, 10 feet apart, covering every inch of ground, and then walked slowly ahead, examining the ground around them as they went. There were 20 officers behind the NCOs, each in charge of a group, making sure they kept in line, making a thorough search of it. They started out at 1 o'clock, combing the buildings, the fields, and then the area known as Lawson's Bush. The trick was to look under every bush, every tree, and not let the line be broken.
And really this case shook everything. It really questioned how our judicial system, our doctors, our lawyers, the military, the OPP, all of them were involved in how this miscarriage of justice came about.
Place beside her.
I don't know how the Harpers managed to continue. I guess you do what you have to, especially with other children to care for, but she was 12 years old. It's your worst nightmare as a parent. No, not even a nightmare. It's the unimaginable hell on earth. We can never know what it was like to be in their shoes. Never.